Oh my God, I firmly believe that you are one God in three divine persons, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. I believe that your divine Son became man and died for our sins, and that he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe this and all the truth which the Holy Catholic Church teaches, because you have revealed them, who are eternal truth and wisdom, who can neither deceive nor be deceived. In this faith, I intend to live and die. Amen. O Lord God, I hope by your grace for the pardon of all my sins, and after life here to gain eternal happiness, because you have promised it, who are infinitely powerful, faithful, kind, and merciful. In this hope, I intend to live and die. Amen. O Lord God, I love you above all things, and I love my neighbor for your sake, because you are the highest, infinite and perfect, worthy of all my love. In this love I intend to live and die. Amen.
The reading from the first book of Samuel. During the time that Samuel was ministered to the Lord with the Levite, a revelation of the Lord was a common and vision prayer. One day, and he was asleep in his usual place, his eyes had lately grown so weary that he could not see. The Lamb of God was not yet extinguished, and Samuel was sleeping in the temple of the Lord where the ark of God was. The Lord called Samuel, who answered, "Here I am." Samuel ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, you called me." "I did not call you," Eli said. "Go back to sleep." So he went back to sleep. Again the Lord called Samuel, who rose and went to Eli. "Here I am," he said. "You call me?" But Eli answered, "I did not call you, my son. Go back to sleep." At that time, Samuel was not familiar with the Lord, because the Lord had not revealed anything to him as yet. The Lord called Samuel again for the third time. Getting up and going to Eli, he said, "Here I am, you call me." Then Eli understood that the Lord was calling the Jew. So Eli said to Samuel, "Go to sleep, and if you were called, reply. Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Today we heard this vocational passage about Samuel, a young minister who was helping the needy, and he was where God was dwelling in the ark. We are gathered also today to pray for you, David and Jordan, as a community of faith, as brothers who are joining together. There is no vocation without community, and this is also a community. As a community, we want to pray for you, be with you, and join. enjoy you in this unique moment, which will mark your heart forever. Samuel is a pivotal figure in the scripture who reaches the gap between the period of the judges and the monarchy and guides Israel's transition to kingship. What I want to highlight today is, in this context, are the attitudes of this young man. First, in the middle of the night, he heard the voice of the Lord. He heard and then took action. As he was sleeping, we can suppose that he stood up and quickly and ran. What an amazing attitude. Heard and ran to answer, to serve. This means that he was attentive for what is needed at that point. It is understandable that he was attentive because he was there ministering and taking care of the Lamb of God, which was about to extinguish. What is interesting is that he heard the voice stand up and run to present himself to a lady. Even more interesting is that he was constant in answering. 3 times he heard the stand up and run and present before the lady. This is a real commitment, real love for minister, for ministry, and for service. He was also confused. He didn't know who was calling him. As many times we are confused, many times we are confused with it. He didn't discern. He just responded. What is very impressive is that the young's endurance to serve his confusion, he was also obedient to the authority at that moment. And he helped him to discern the instructions for the next time he heard a voice. Eli was the mediator of God for Samuel. God used him as an instrument of discernment for Samuel. The young man was obedient to that man and did exactly what Eli had recommended. Finally, because of his perseverance, Samuel answered God with authenticity, generosity, and humility as a faithful servant. This is a key word, servant. Deacon means, as Acts of the Apostles says in chapter 6, in that chapter, he tells us that how the apostles appointed 7 men because they take care of the widows whose number was growing and serving the table. Service is not something strange for you. You have been serving your communities, many ministries, in Catholic churches, for example, at the hospital, in your CPD, in the different commissions that you have as seminarians and also as our former president. So, you know how to serve, and you have been a good testimony of this willingness to serve. This willingness to serve is found in those who have had an encounter and a call from God. You are about to be ordained as a deacon. It is a tremendous gift, which is given especially to you for the good of the people of God. It is a responsibility, but at the same time, it is a great privilege to serve the people of God. There is a temptation, I think, as a that you can think that your ministry is only in liturgical services. Besides the presider, sitting at the altar, giving the body of Christ, or giving blessings. That is great, but it is not all, from my point of view. The temptation should be feeling comfortable there by the sanctuary and not move forward to live the most authentic identity of what it means being a deacon, which is being a servant. The first deacons were appointed to serve, especially the widows who served at the table, those who were poor. So you ask and you knew charisma because it's not fulfilled if you stay only in the liturgical tasks and forget or put aside the main purpose of your ministry, serve the widows and the poor. In the times of the first Christian community, the widows were one of the least persons in the Jewish society. They didn't have any social value with the men who socially represented them. So the deacons were appointed to take care of those erroneously marginalized persons who are nowadays those widows. I mean, who are these? Who are the most marginalized people? Who are the poorest in our society or here in our seminary? They are your first responsibility. We trust in you, and we are proud of you. Go to the peripheries to help, to serve, to watch the feet of those most in need, those most marginalized, those who are hungry of God. Serve them. As Samuel, may this Saturday, not your ministry as a transitional deacons, again and again, be able to answer to God and say, speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.
Thank you. God our Father, you've called us in baptism to follow your Son Jesus through lives of love and service to you and to one another. Grant us your assistance, guided by the Holy Spirit, to live out our vocation in life. We pray, especially for those who answer their call as priests, brothers, sisters, deacons, and lay ministers. Keep them faithful in following your Son and dedicated in serving their brothers and sisters. Grant that many more men and women will be open to the challenge of dedicating their lives and the ministry of building your kingdom. We ask this in Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. Holy and Providential Father, thank you for all the priests, consecrated women and men serving in the Diocese of San Antonio. Sanctify them, heal them, guide them, mold them into the likeness and holiness of your Son, Jesus, the Good Shepherd. May their lives be pleasing to you by living their vocation with joy and generosity. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
God the Father of heaven,
have mercy on us.
God the Son, Redeemer of the world,
have mercy on us.
God the Holy Spirit,
have mercy on us.
Holy Trinity, one God,
have mercy on us.
Holy Mary,
pray for us.
Holy Mother of God,
pray for us.
Holy Virgin of Virgins,
pray for us.
St. Michael, Leader of the Heavenly Host,
pray for us.
St. Gabriel, Messenger of God's Divine Plan,
pray for us.
St. Raphael, Companion of the Journey,
pray for us.
All you holy angels and archangels,
pray for us.
St. Joseph, Protector of the Holy Church,
pray for us.
St. John Vianney, Patron of Greece,
pray for us.
St. Aloysius and Saga, Patron of Youth,
pray for us.
St. Alphonsus Liguori, Patron of Vocations,
pray for us.
St. Charles Borromeo, Patron of Seminarians,
pray for us.
St. John Merchants, Patron of Altar Servers,
pray for us.
St. Maria Ruelli, Patron of Teenagers,
pray for us.
St. Anthony of Padua, Patron of the Archdiocese,
pray for us.
All you holy men and women,
pray for us. Let us pray. O God, who choose the apostles to make disciples of all nations, and who by baptism and confirmation has called us to build up your holy church, we implore you to choose among us your children,
many priests and religious who will love you with their whole heart and will gladly spend their entire lives making you known
and loved by all. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
You have given them bread from heaven. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, you gave us the Eucharist as the memorial of your suffering and death. May our worship of the sacrament of your body and blood help us to experience the salvation you won for us and the peace of the kingdom, where you live with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed be God.
Blessed
be His holy name.
Blessed be His holy name.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Blessed be His most sacred heart.
Blessed be His most sacred heart.
Blessed be His most precious blood.
Blessed be His most precious blood.
Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete.
Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete.
Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy.
Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy.
Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception.
Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception.
Blessed be her glorious assumption.
Blessed be her glorious assumption.
Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother.
Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother.
Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse.
Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse.
Blessed be God in His angels and in His saints.
Blessed be God in His angels and in His saints.
Amen.
Yes, Father.